Welcome everyone. So today we are continuing with the exercise 1.3, and day before yesterday we have done exercise 1.3 question number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 I have given you for homework. I don't know how many of you have done question number 5th. So right now I am starting with question number 5th. Okay, and I have already done question number 5th. You need to just check it whether your answer is correct or wrong. Okay, in question number 5th, no, they are asking for what can be the maximum number of digits be in the repeating block of digits in the decimal expansion of 1 by 17. It means when you will divide 1 by 17, when you will divide 1 by 17, then how many digits will be in the repeating mode? Okay, after decimal, this we need to check. So this division I have told you, it will be a little bigger division like this. Look here, it has started like this. Let me explain you. 1 we have to divide by 17. Now here we have point, with point we can write 0, then with one more 0 we can write 0, then with 8, 17, 5 is 85. Like this we will start. So 0.3 is same, 0.05, then 5 is 85. Now remainder is 15. In this way, if you will keep on dividing, no, these numbers will come. Okay, these numbers will keep on coming. And there is no repetition. Till now, there is no repetition. Now see why I have stopped after this. After this, why I have stopped after the after these many digits? Because I got the remainder. I got remainder 1 this time. And we have started with also 1. We have started here with 1 and I got the remainder 1. It means after this, these all digits will going to repeat. So how many digits are in repeating mode? Let's check this. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So there are 16 digits which are in repetition mode. So we can write. See, you can note it down or you can take here the screenshot or you can pause the video and you can write. Okay, this is the division or you can do this division. It's very easy. But where to stop? When the same number 1 will come, then we have to stop at this time. Okay, because it means after this, the same all division will get repeat and same numbers here will get repeat. Okay, so how many digits are there? 16 digits are there. So we'll write our answer as in question number 5, we'll write. Number of digits in the repeating mode, number of digits in the repeating mode, in the repeating block, repeating block is equals to 16, and you have to write the answer also the same which is written here. Okay, what is the answer? The same we will write. 0.588 23 52 9411 7647 and bar on all these. Okay, so this is answer. After this, let us move on to the next question, which is important, and this property is important. This will help you in 10th grade also. Look at several examples of rational numbers in the form of p by q. Now you have to take different examples that I have given you in the very first exercise even. When p and q are integers with no common factors other than 1. Okay, it means it is a rational number and having terminating decimal expansion. What it is written, please focus on this line. And this this is written in the form of p by q. It has terminating decimal expansion. Terminating decimal means where remainder will be 0. It means we can divide these two numbers completely. So terminating decimal expansion, if we have, then what property q must satisfy? Then what should be the property of q? Means if we have, see, I am doing question number 6. First of all, I am explaining in rough. If we have something in the form of p by q, for example 1 by 3 I has, then if I'll divide this, no, then I'll get 0.333 and so on, and 0.3 bar, because we'll not be able to get remainder 0 in this case. See, divide is a 9 and 1 0 we can write, 3 is a 9, it will keep on going like this. So you can write this 1.1 upon 3 is equal to 0.3 bar. Now one more. 1 upon 10. Here I know that it will be able to divide it properly. 0.0, then 10 ones are 10 and remainder is 0. So in this case, we got remainder 0. It means 1 by 10 is what? Terminating. What they are talking about, we have to look for terminating decimal expansion. See, this is terminating, but this is not terminating because here remainder is not 0. Now let us take few more examples. I am taking now 2, 8, 4, 4. Okay, I am taking now 8 dividing 7 by 8. Will remainder be 0? Let us check. 0.0 8 is 64, 6 0, 7 is 56, 4 0, 5 is 40. So I got remainder 0. So just look at the factors now. Okay, one more I can take for example, 2 divided by 25. Can I get remainder 0? Let us check. 25 and 2, then 0.0. Wait, let me write it again. 0.0. It is not possible to divide. Again 0, then 0. Then 8 is 200. Again remainder is 0. Now see these all. What is the property of Q? What do you mean by Q? Q here is the denominator. Q is the denominator. Q is the denominator. And here also Q is the denominator. Now see the property of this all. Here the factor, here the Q is 3 and here Q is 10, here Q is 8 and here Q is 25. And 25 can be written as 5 square, 8 can be written as 2 cube and 10 can be written as 2 into 5. And this is only 3. Okay. Now see, these all are the examples where we got remainder 0. We got remainder here also 0. We got remainder here also 0. See, these all are the examples of remainder 0, means these all are what? Terminating. Terminating, if they are terminating, and what is Q here? We have to tell the property of Q. Means Q should contain either 2 or 5 or 2 or 5 together. Then it can divide any number. If in the denominator we have 2 and 5 as factors, or alone 2 or alone 5, then it can divide any number. It means if you're dividing it by 2, if you're dividing any number by 2, 4, 8, 16, see, these all contains only factors 2 or 25 or 50, okay, because they also contain 2 and 5 as factors. You can check the factors of 50, 2, 25, 5, 5, 5, 1, only 2 and 5 as factor. 2 contains only 2, 4 contains 2 square, this is 2 cube, and this is 2 raised to the power 4, this is 2 raised to the power 5. So we have only either 2 in the factors or we have 2 or 5 as factor. This is what? 5 square. If you divide any number by these numbers, no? These numbers, you will get always remainder 0. It means, what is the property of Q? See, I have explained too much for this. But answer is in only one line. Q must be in the form of 2 raised to power m into 5 raised to power n. Q must be in the form of 2 raised to power m means Q should have only 2 and 5 as factors. And there can be any number of 2. That's why I have written here a power. There can be any number of 5. That's why I have written here a power. Have you understood this? Means if here it is written that it should be terminating decimal. If it is terminating, for terminating, this property Q must have. If Q is satisfying this property, no, it means it is terminating. It means without doing division, we'll get to know that it is terminating or not. Now you have to tell me. 1 by 6. Will 1 is divisible by 6 or we'll get remainder 0? Here in 6, we have 2 and 3 as factors. It means we have 2, but we have additional 3. 3 is not permittable. Okay, according to the question, it should be only 2 and 5 as factors. If any other factor will come, it means it is non-terminating. Okay, 1 by 7, non-terminating. 1 by 8, 8 has only 2s factor, only 2 will work. So it is terminating. What it is written here, 2 and 5. Means alone 2 can also work, alone 5 can also work, and together 2 and 5 will also work. Okay, it will terminate the number. So this is over with this. Now, let us move on to question number 7. Let us move on to question number 7 now. Now, let us move on to question number 7. Okay. See this. Write three numbers whose decimal expansion are non-terminating and non-recurring. Now, any three numbers will work. Okay, let me write first, second and third. Their decimal expansion should be non-terminating, means non-terminating, and non-recurring, non-repeating also. Write any number. I am starting with 2.31, 30, 3000, 3000, dash, dash. Is there any number in repetition mode? No, this is 31, this is 30, this is 300, this is 3000, nothing is in repetition. So it is non-terminating first of all because it is keep on going. And the second thing is, it is non-repeating also. So what is this? This is the example of irrational number. What we have written here? What we have to write here? Irrational numbers we have to write. Because irrational numbers are those which are non-terminating and non-repeating. One more. 11.12212212. Why I am writing like this in sequence, then 1212. In this way, you will be able to judge that, yeah, here the numbers are not repeating, and even it is keep on going, so it is non-terminating. Again, 3.30, 3222, 3, and so on. Okay, so these all are non-terminating and non-recurring. Non-recurring means non-repeating. Now, come to this important question. Okay, how to find irrational numbers between any two rational numbers? Listen carefully. How to find irrational numbers between any two rational numbers? So, we have to find three rational numbers. So, the number is 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. Let us write 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. And 9 by 11. If you will divide 5 by 7, then you will get 0.0, 7's are 49, 10, 1's are 7. Okay, then after this, it will keep on going. So, but I am not dividing, I am just writing a number approximate to this. 7 per dash, 7 1 dash is dash, then 9 divided by 11, 0.0, then 8's are 88, then 2, 0. 1's are 11. Now I am not going further. Okay. Let it be 0.81 dash is dash. Now, how to write three irrational numbers? Three irrational. The way I have written there, no? In this question, the way I have written, in the same way you have to write. Okay. But how to write this? See this. 0.71, it is starting and it is ending here with 0.81. So we can write many numbers in between. We can start with 0.72 or we can either start with 0.71 also. So, but we will start on a safer side, 0.72 or 73 and 74. Okay. So 0.72, 7222, 7222 in this way. The first irrational number and the second. 0.73717111711 means any kind of you can write. Okay, 0.74712711112. Okay, 71112 means you have to show there is no sequence at all. Means there is no there is no repetition of the same number at all. Okay, sequence I am making just by my own 71, 711, 7111. It is showing that it is not repeating. The same 71, 71, 71 is not repeating. These are different number all always. So here it is 712, then 7112, 7112. It means the same 712 is not repeating again and again. Okay, so these are non-terminating and non-repeating. So this way we can write three irrational numbers in between. So 8th question is also done. So let us move on to question number 9. Question number 9. We will discuss here only question number 9. question number 9. See, classify the following as rational or irrational. What is this? Root 23. Rational or irrational? See, 23, we do not have any factors of 23 and it is under root. I have told you that numbers in root are irrational numbers. So, directly we can write it as irrational number. Second, root 25. Root 225. See this. Root 225. 225 is a factor of, is the square of 15. So, we can write 15 into 15 and 15 will come out. And what is this 15? A rational number. Okay, we need to solve sometimes. So, rational number. And this is simple, 0.3796, rational number. So, here also, it is non-terminating, but it is repeating. And non-terminating, but repeating is always a rational number. Here it is non-terminating, but it is not repeating. See, 101, 1001, 1001, the way I have written down, no, in the same way they have written. So, it is irrational number. So, we have done with this exercise and this 1.3 exercise is all over. So, now we can start with exercise 1.4. Okay. Let's start. About page number 18. Page number 18, NCERT and exercise 1.4. It is all about number line. See, you know how to represent rational number or number line. But if a number is a rational number, but the decimal expansion is in the repeating mode, then how to represent that? For example, question number 1, you can see. This is a simple question with 3.765. How to represent? The method called magnification will represent the number line by magnification method. Okay, now how to magnify it? First of all, many some number lines will make. First of all, this 3. See, for the first number, what is this? 3. So, we have to represent first of all 3. For that, how we can do? Wait, I am just making a number line. Okay, I am making a little rough. You have to make it just fair with scale and proper gap. Okay, so you can make 0, minus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now here we can mark no. It comes, this number comes in between 3 and 4. So, we'll mark here 3 and 4. Okay, after marking here 3 and 4, then we can start with, one more number line. The next number line we'll make now. Let me choose the pen. Okay, you also keep on making with me. Okay, now starting with the main number here is 3 and here the main number will be 4 and in between we have to write 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4, 3.5, 3.6, 3.7, 3.8, 3.9, then we will write 4. So this we have written means do not write first of all 4 means at the end you should write this the way I have done mistake. See, I am rubbing it. 4 will come this side. Now how to show this 3 we have written here? No, then we'll do like this, that this is here and this 4 written this side and in between we have written all the numbers from 3.1 to 3.9. now it will come between which number? Now the next is 7. So 7 will come between this 3.7 and 3.8. So we'll mark here 3.7 and here 3.8. Just wait, let me rub these extra numbers. Okay, now how to make now we'll start with 3.7 and we'll end at 3.8. now again let me make the line. Let's wait. Okay, now we are starting at 3.7. Okay, you can write in this way also, 3.71. Okay, it will be easier for you to write, right? 3.72, 3.73, and the same way 3.74. So all you can write in this way if you will write, no, vertically, it will be easy for you to manage the space. 3.75, in the same way 3.76, in the same way you can write till the end. So in this way we can write, and we can rub this line, means we see we all have to make this with pencil. Okay, so we can rub the extra line. So it is now between 3.7 and 3.8 we have made. So let us mark it that from 3.7 we have shown here and 3.8 here. So we have magnified in between 3.71 to 3.79. So in this way, in between, now we have to move to 3.76, no? So it is between 3.76 and 3.77. Let us mark these points, 3.76 and 3.77. Now we have to magnify it more. Okay, so let me make the line again. Wait. Okay, with this we can start with 3.76. Okay, then again a first point, 3.761. In this way we'll start making. Okay, and you can make in the same manner. Let me make. So in this way we can make. I have made for you. Okay, so see this 3.761 762 76 3 76 4 76 5, then 7 6 6 7 6 7 7 6 8 7 6 9, and 3.77 after that. Then we can rub this extra line that we have made. Okay, now see this, what they have asked for, they have asked for 3.765, and we have got this 3.765. so this is our representation of 3.765 on number line by magnification method. Okay, and this we can make a line that like this, and these numbers we have shown here. Okay, this way you can make. So this way you can do question number one of 1.4. the same way question number two also you have to do. You can take the example also, you can take the help of the example also. Example number 11, you also, you can see if you have any doubt. Okay, the how they have represented, but you can see my method, the same method they have used. Okay, question number 2, now it is 4.26 bar. It is 4.26 bar, and it is written that visualize 4.26 bar on the number line up to 4 decimal places. 4 decimal places means 4.2626. So till 2626 only we have to represent. So for these 3 decimal places we have made 1, 2, 3, 4 number lines. And for these 4 decimal places we will make 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5th number line also. Then you will be able to do this question. I hope you have, if you have understood this, you can represent 4.2626 also on the number line. Okay, what we have to represent 4.2626 now, because they have said till 4 decimal places. So 26 will be in repetition mode, so 2626 will make 4 decimal places here. So in the same manner you have to do. If you will not be able to do this question, you can ask me, comment below, sir please in the next video explain me question number 2, then I'll explain you question number 2 in the next video. Otherwise we'll continue with exercise 1.5 in the next video. Okay, so I hope you have understood what is your homework. That's all for today. The lecture is over now. Homework is complete exercise 1.3 in notebook. In 1.3, which questions we have done today? Question number 5 to question number 9. After that, exercise 1.4 also in notebook. Full, only 2 questions we have in this. Okay, and in this, use scale and pencil to make number line. Fine. With proper gap. Proper gap means same gap. If you are taking 1 centimeter, then take 1 centimeter gap. If you are taking 2 centimeter, then take 2 centimeter gap in between here. I am talking about in between this. The gap should be same between every number. Fine. So this is your homework for today. Bye. Take care. Thank you.